Guys, I want to help you out. I want to reach out to you. And if you don't like that, you can suck these nuts.
And welcome to another episode of Reaching Out to the Unfamous. Let's look at some very talented artists today, shall we? First on the list, we have a guy named Philip So of South Korea. This guy has a very interesting character. His name is Count Billy. Of course, he has to have a count in his name because he's a serious regality, you know? He's very regal, very formal. Now, whereas Philip himself is Korean, his character Philip is German, and thus serves as Philip So's own character, and thus his alternate ego, so to speak. Which I think it's actually very, very interesting to have an alter ego. I myself have an alternate ego, which I am speaking as right now. But anyway, back to the story. The origins of his character go back quite a bit, back to around, I would say, the mid-2000s. I first started looking at his work around, I'd say, starting from a few months before I became an official DeviantArt member, namely with, say, a picture like, say, this one. This was one of the first ones that I looked at, and this character's design is actually very interesting, very unique, very gifted. And So's artwork is very, very awesome, I should say. Very intriguing. Very, very intriguing, I should say. Very intriguing. So intriguing, in fact, that Philip So, not the character, but the person, has a very interesting taste in classical music, as do I. And I personally applaud him for that, because it shows in his artwork, and he's a very talented artist, although he never really considers himself to be one, but that he draws because it's something that he enjoys. And I very much like that. If he only does this as a hobby, imagine, my friends, what he would be capable of if he actually did this seriously. If he took drawing and art very seriously, how would you think his art would turn out? Would it be like something out of an anime, like Kill la Kill or something like that? By the way, go watch that anime, it's very, very interesting. Especially notable for several characters, but you get the idea. Continuing with this artwork now, I've compiled a list of my favorite personal arts regarding his character, Philip, and I'd like to show that to you now. It's so intriguing to me now that I think about it, because the drawings that he made of his character over the years has improved quite a bit. Of course, some of these characters might or might not have been drawn by himself, but rather as personal commissions. You know, I mean, I don't know that, but that's just my speculating. I can't assume, because there's an old adage used to say, if you assume, you make an ass of you and me, which is completely another thing. Meanwhile, this character has undergone an very... By the way, this is... I don't know what to say about this because, of course, many people are inspired by classical music, and that says a lot. Meanwhile, Philip So's character, Count Philip, is also very experienced in Taekwondo, or Taekwondo, I should say. Forgive me for mispronouncing that. but I can tell just by the way this character has evolved over the years that he has a very unique style of his own in terms of fighting stance, which you can see very clearly on one of his submissions on his Furfinity account. And he also has a DeviantArt account, as well as a blog of his own. You may already know his blog, and I'm not sure exactly where I found it originally, but if ever I need to link it to you, I will, and in fact, I'll be more than glad to, following this video, the links of which, of course, you will find in the description, and also, mind you, this is just a sample of his work. Of course, he's also been known to draw automobiles, you know, sketches of automobiles, of helicopters, both of which I find just as fascinating and just as neatly well drawn. And therefore, that solidifies Philip So's very profitable ability as a hobbyist artist of some sort of light. And it's with that reason that I include him on the list of artists which I believe wholeheartedly you should check out, especially considering his art is well known in some places, and considering he's done this for a long, long time. I honestly believe that he has a lot of truth to his art, a lot of inspiration. So go check his stuff out. You may end up not ever wanting to leave because his art is that entertaining and that intriguing. It almost has some kind of a mystique to it, mind you. Anyhow, let's go to another artist I really like. This time from DeviantArt, of course I'm talking about the man who calls himself Cotafilus. I'm talking about Creatio X Nihil Zero here. Has a distinct and very original array of different art styles and guises. As you look down his gallery, you will find very interesting artworks, some of which are traditional, some of which are digital, others which are abstract, in the most ironical ways, mind you. And his unique sense of perspective is also very distinct, very genuine, very clear-cut, very well executed. I'm telling you people this because I know firsthand, because I'm looking at his artwork now, and I can only guess that that's probably why he is following me now on Twitter, because I noticed a couple of his artworks, and I put them into one of my galleries dedicated to all artists resembling different walks of life and different talents, you know, basically the gifted. And there are gifted people who come from any creed, any country, any nationality, any walk of life in general. But as you look down this gallery, you will find that his artwork is very, very intriguing, almost dreamlike, like something out of an illusion, out of a computerized illusion, especially with his digital work. Now, might I remind you all that his digital work stands out to me because it's very abstract, exponentially realistic in all its ironic glory. Of course, he also has some photographs too, which are also just as much noteworthy as the rest of his other stuff. And of course, he experiments very well with neutral colors, as you will see. He has unbelievable styles. And that, of course, dates back to his first artworks which he submitted about a month or so ago when he first joined DDDot. And I must say, with absolute clarity and confidence, the extreme emotions and feelings and moods that he puts into his artwork in pretty much every submission that he accepts into his gallery. Every folder that he has in his gallery particularly, they are all extremely unique in ways which not even myself can describe or accurately explain. Thus, Ratio X Nihil Zero is most assuredly worthy of my praise and my admiration for having adopted so many different techniques, so many different art styles and genres, notably traditional, digital, abstract, and photography. And for that, Ratio X Nihil Zero, we here at Skull Media Enterprises thank you for having created this incredible gallery of art in which we, the viewing audience, are most privileged and honored to see you. By the way, go check his DeviantArt out, BracioXNihilZero@DeviantArt.com. He may also have a Twitter, which I may be able to link you to following the video itself, within its description, mind you. Next up we have, this is one of his works in particular, a very interesting work I should say. It's called The Distortionist. And the reason why it's called The Distortionist is because of this woman here, with this very odd looking baseball bat. I'm pretty sure this distorted bat that was drawn in this light was very intentional, supposedly to serve a purpose in this picture, hence why the picture is called Distortion, or The Distortionists. That's without the second T in the end, but with a third S, or whatever. The point is, the fact is pretty simple. This artist has a very gifted style. I look at literally thousands of different artworks every single day, and a lot of these, like this one, very well catch my eye, even if only for a brief glance. But those that particularly intrigue me are also those that I can very much relate to in very, very interesting ways and guises. And this artist, of course, will get to the rest of his gallery later, but this artist in particular has a very unique style all his own, and it is very well documented that his art has a very realistic feel to it, meaning it's genuine, it's original, in a very surprising way. And of course there's a description in this particular picture that reads, "Tears laced with cyanide flow through the cracks of a mirror shattered long ago." And sure, I'm the one who swung the metal bat, but hey, I can't control the urge. Nobody's gonna blame me for that. And with good reason. And this picture serves as a very, very clear-cut, crystallized example of that. Set in stone for all the world to see. And with that, I'd like to introduce you all to the rest of his gallery. And believe me, you're going to love his gallery, because he has very interesting stuff in there that I believe is very noteworthy. There is a musical poem there. I think you might have heard that term in a recent commercial that was narrated by some animated owl in some kind of rich man's costume playing behind the piano there, but that's just one thing. As for this one, let's go to his gallery. A very privileged and very boss-like artist named Endora, or Rendoya. She is a German artist, last name Schmidt, whose deviations are unquestionably very intriguing in their own way, and also very mysterious, very dark in some cases, very macabre, if you will. She, of course, is inspired by many things in life, as am I. And she's also inspired by the Renaissance and Romantic eras of human history, which I can clearly see in quite a couple of her artworks. And just like me, she's a brony, except she's not a male, she's female. Technically I'm male, so that would make me a brony. But what would female bronies be called? Oh, I don't know. Well, you figured that out on your own, just look it up. Anyhow, judging by these particular artworks, and the ones that she considers to be inspirations to her, and of course she has a Facebook, and she encourages all of you, just as much as I do, to check out her artwork there, and her posts. And please, 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 for God's sake, give her a follow, because she deserves a hell of a lot more followers than I do. And I might have only 378 followers over there on Facebook, but honestly, I'm fine where I am. You can watch my Facebook if you want, that's your choice, I won't force you to. But anyway, looking at her artwork, noticing everything, and she also happened to have an old account of the username Nico Caffrey, which, by the way, may also have artworks that are just as good, but I don't know if that was deactivated or not. So, she's also a fan of chainmails, or chain comments, or whatever. I stopped being a fan of that a long, long time ago, for reasons I won't discuss, but that's just me, that's how I am. And, the fact is, she is very intriguing as an artist, and I very much like her work. That being said, I'd like to direct you all and your attention, mind you, towards her gallery, which I think you will very much enjoy. And by turds, I mean drawers. Notice I'm mispronouncing words here. That's because I'm an artist, and there are lots of those around, so don't be surprised. There are lots of noteworthy pieces here that I think you will very much enjoy, and personally, I like those particular drawings of hers. I think they are very unique, very, you know, they're authentic. They're authentic. And with damn good reason, mind you. Keep in mind that just because she is a woman doesn't automatically mean that she's not as gifted as any of her male counterparts, because she is, in fact, and possibly much more. So just so you know, the more you know, the better off you'll be. The point is, she's only made perhaps maybe several dozen works over the time in which she created this new account and now, but even though she doesn't have many artworks in her gallery, that doesn't mean that she's not consistent, because just in her artwork alone, you can tell that her consistency drives her, because she spends quite a bit of time on these pieces, I would imagine. A hell of a lot more time, much more time than most will let on. And I can see that in her artwork. And I also notice here, look at this. Her latest works, for example. These are all very unique. They're quite interesting, you know? I can't even describe the words here. I'm just spellbound by these compositions that she's bestowed upon the world. And I just don't know what to say about it, personally. I mean, not that it matters, but you get the picture. Right. Okay. I can see very clearly with my own two eyes that she has developed her own style even long before she made this account. Keep in mind, she had a previous one, but I can't say for sure whether or not it's still active, because I have not checked it out myself. But if ever you want to check it out, just type her old username, which you will see in her profile, and then add to it in the web address, .deviantart.com, and then press enter, and of course you will get your answer. But getting back to this topic, you know, the artwork that she's bestowed upon us, it's kind of surreal, very, very surreal, like something that you would see in some kind of a movie, except all the movies in Hollywood are not like they should be presented in galleries like this one. Galleries like this are the reason as to why Hollywood should stop producing CG-related, over-liberalistic garbage and start promoting stuff that's more, say, less politically correct, more realistic, more back to reality, if you will. And at the same time, they can keep their CGI effects, their special effects or whatever, as long as they drop the political correctness of it. And of course, we have to have more artists like this, because, let me tell you, this woman's artwork is vastly incredible, and I urge you all to check it out. And Rindoria, I know that you might not be watching this now when it airs on YouTube, but when you do get a chance to see it, you'll understand that I am totally impressed with your artwork, and I think you have a very magnificent style that simply cannot be ignored by anybody. You have a very noticeable gallery, and your art is absolutely outstanding. It is gold. And for that, we at Skull Media Enterprises thank you for your contributions. So, go check her artwork out. You will never be disappointed, I can tell you that. Reaching out to the unfamous has been brought to you by Dolby Atmos, who remind you all that having an adorable little girl from the Moonbot Studios movie Silent with the product itself playing the sound in the background is key for a noteworthy, realistic experience. And I'm talking about just the ears though, just visually, just soundly. You understand? I mean, fuck, nothing about this, but I mean, I just totally said that wrong. It's also been sponsored by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, not sponsored, which is paid and bought for by suckers like you. Have a nice day. Well, that first season went down the toilet like a fucking ball of shit, didn't it? I mean, I can't keep holding the socks in forever, but still, have a nice day. Goodbye. want my permission to download this video, message me on any of my social media channels and ask for it, and I'll give you my IK. And above all else, don't be a jackass. Please, be real. Don't steal.